Everyone, it's Greg Curley, West Ham Fan TV. Welcome to the big match preview. The Europa League returns to the London Stadium Thursday night at 8 p.m. where we take on Dynamo Zagreb. A game for us, which is a bit of a dead rubber. Already qualified, already top of the group. But Zagreb, on the other hand, need to get a result if they guarantee their spot in the next round of the Europa League. Genk breathing down their necks, only 2 points behind. They take on bottom side Vienna. So they've got to be favourites to win this one. So, you know, Zagreb under a lot of pressure. Not in the best of form of late. Only won two of their last six fixtures and lost their last two games back to back as well. So a lot of pressure on them going into this game. Whereas for us, we can relax. We can go and enjoy a game of football and enjoy ourselves. And it's a chance, you know, with the injuries that we've picked up, some youngsters could step into the fray, you know, and improve their chances of getting in. It gives them opportunities. We've got other fringe players as well who will take this opportunity to try and make the manager think. Because as I said, we've got a lot of games coming up at the moment and we're going to need to use the squad that we've got, especially with those injuries that we picked up to Zouma and Johnson at the weekend. You know, players like Baptiste, who hopefully will get a look in this game. You know, he's got a point to prove. He's got an opportunity to step up to the plate and show the gaffer that, look, these players are out injured, but I'm fully capable of stepping in and doing the job. And that's what we want to see. Zagreb going into this game, the stats are stacked against them. They've never won against English opponents away from home, and they've lost all their five visits to the capital. So, you know, it doesn't make pretty reading from them. And as I said, with the form that they're in at the moment, this is going to be a tough game for them as much as it is for us. Zagreb are fully fit and fully got everybody available. Whereas, as we know, we're missing a Bonner. Creswell, who has returned to training and should be back for the Burnley fixture. Kurt Zouma and Ben Johnson are also missing. You know, we've lost our entire back line, which just goes to show the depth that we have got in the squad with players like Diop and Dawson who can step in, Soufal, and obviously Masuaku. And we've got a few youngsters who can fill in them positions. Masuaku, for me, isn't the greatest left-back, so hopefully we get to see one of the youngsters play in that left-back position, if not on the right, and Soufal play on the left. So it'd be interesting to see what Moyes does. He has a lot of options. He could switch to the three at the back, as we saw at the start against Chelsea. You know, bring in Baptiste and play Baptiste, Diop and Dawson. But does he want to risk playing Diop and Dawson? Will he give one of those two a rest and we see Baptiste alongside Dawson or alongside Diop? Be interesting to see what Moisey wants to do going into this game. Zagreb, I fully expect to line up a 4-4-1-1 system with Petrovic leading the line. He's obviously their top goal scorer, so he's going to be the main threat going into this game, a player that we're going to need to keep an eye on. But, you know, as I've said in previous Europa League games, players have stepped in and players have done a job. Yarmolenko, you know, he in the last Europa League game got a goal. You know, Vlasic needs to still prove a point. He's still learning, you know, readapting to joining the club. As we saw with Benrahma, Moyes is sort of bringing him in slowly, trying to bed him in and give him every opportunity that he can. Kroll is another one. You know, he's come into the side a couple of times and played really well. He's a bit unfortunate with picking up COVID, which obviously set him back a bit. But I fully expect him to start in this one alongside Mark Noble in the centre of midfield. I don't think, personally, we should risk Rice and Souček going into this fixture. So let's give Kroll and Noble a start. They've done the job before for us, so let's give them the opportunity to do it again. And, you know, hopefully blood a couple more youngsters as well. Get to see these players coming out and get, you know, a lot of us fans don't get to see the under-23s, don't get to see the under-18s. So it's good when we see these young players. We hear a lot about them, but it'd be good to see what they can do. And I like the fact that Moyes never seems to throw them all in at the deep end. He brings a player in here, a player in there, so they're not all, the pressure's not all on them. You know, they're just there to try and slot in alongside the so-called senior players. And, you know, that's a good thing to see, and that's what we want to see in this fixture as well. So, yeah, it's going to be an interesting game, but as I said, there's no pressure on us. It'd be nice to go there, see a good game of football, and hopefully go on to get the win. Thank you very much for watching. We will be around after the game if you want to come and get yourself on a fan cam. Come and see us as you face the club shop. We are to the left by the programme stall that's there. So, yeah, come and say hello or come get yourself on a fan cam. And we will also be travelling up to Burnley as we usually do to every game. I'll be back on probably Friday slash Saturday with a build up to the Burnley game. Also, you know, I'll be on Friday Night Pint as well, so make sure you check out all that. Thank you very much for watching. One thing left to say, come on you Lions.